Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. Today, I want to talk to you about freeze-dried foods, emergency foods, and why it's so important. First, I got my concealed carry permit renewed here in Kentucky. We call it the Carrying Concealed Deadly Weapons Permit, and it includes firearms as well as knives and other weapons as well. So I can legally carry that in the state of Kentucky. It actually recently passed a constitutional carry law here in Kentucky, so you don't actually need a permit to carry. That's the new change they're going to have here in Kentucky, but of course, I plan on going to other states, so it's important for me to have a permit issued by the state of Kentucky, so when I go to Virginia or Tennessee or some other state, Michigan, I still have a valid permit. Those states require you to have a state permit, permit that's been issued by your state residency in order for them to recognize your right to conceal carry. I know a lot of people think that, oh, well, you know, you shouldn't need a permit. I understand that. But the fact of the matter is, this is what we're dealing with, and I'm taking measures to make sure that I'm able to legally carry concealed weapons throughout Kentucky and firearm wherever I go. Well, unless I go to California or New York or someplace like that, or Maryland. But anyway, I won't be going there anytime soon. I might visit New York, but that's going to be a whole other issue. Freeze-dried foods. Here's the deal. Emergency situations, you want to be able to provide your own emergency food. You want emergency food that won't perish easily, that's gonna be easy for you to carry. And for me, this is the best solution. All right guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. Today, I'm gonna be looking at Mountain House food. I decided to go ahead and get some more freeze-dried food simply because this stuff can last 30 years, really. 25, 30 years. I really only need it to last 10 to 15 years for it to really be worth it. And for me, now this is pretty much the best freeze-dried food that I've been able to find. You can find some off-brand companies, but you gotta be careful because some of these companies, you know, like one particular company has a lawsuit filed against it, a class action lawsuit filed against it, but that's not Mountain House. Just be careful which companies you actually go with. I like the fact that Mountain House has been around for a long time, and the fact that, you know, if I want to find, there's actually Mountain House products that's been around for decades. You know, you've seen some people test some of the stuff on YouTube. So I'm a bit weary of the newer companies because they don't have that track record. So that's really important to me. But anyway, Mountain House, it can be pricey, but you know, you get what you pay for. With this stuff, I like Beef Saginaw. This is one of my favorite types. It's all pretty much the same food in here. And decided to get a pack of these. Also decided to go ahead and get a bucket of the essentials. Essentials, this is the meal essential, the essential pack. Now the way these work is you get some water, you boil some water, pour it in here, the proper amount, whether it be, you know, 1 cup or 2 cups or 1.5 cups, just follow directions, just pour the hot water in there. And wait about 10 minutes or so, and it's pretty much due. Now, the essential meal pack actually comes with, it says 32 servings. Let's see what we have. Chicken and rice. Okay. They also have spaghetti. They also have chili mac. Really good options. Now, below, you have the classic. Right here, you have 2 beef Saginaw with noodles. You have 2 beef stew. 2 chicken teriyaki with rice, 2 lasagnas with meat sauce, 2 noodles and chicken, and you have the granola with the milk and blueberries. So I like the fact that they come in their own bucket and just grab one and go. I'm gonna get a lot more of these, but it's gonna be a little bit at a time. It's also important to have a means of boiling water. Now you can always start a fire outside, but if you're in the city, you want to be able to set your actually boil water with a means of not really attracting too much attention to yourself. So you can get like a little pocket rocket or something like that. There's a lot of different options we'll explore on this channel, but just a quick look.
Right, one of the biggest advantages to using freeze-dried food is that the heaviest component of the food is removed, and that's water. So you can add the water later on. You can simply boil the water, put it in the pouch, seal the pouch, let it heat up and cook for 10 minutes. Then you have your food ready. And this makes it easy for you to transport it from point A to point B. So even if you're planning on bugging in like I am, if you have to bug out, then you know it's easier for you to grab your food. This stuff is lightweight, it weighs practically nothing. That's one of the pleasant surprises about dealing with freeze-dried food. So make sure you're dealing with something that's a quality product from a company that's been doing it for a long, long time. Again, if you're buying something that's supposedly going to last for 20 or 30 years, you know, you don't want to start with a company that hasn't been around for not even two or three. You know, so for me, that's the route I'm taking. I'm not going to spend too much more money on canned goods unless it's the freeze-dried canned goods from Mountain House or some other company that is designed to last for a long time. So that's my strategy. Guys, share your thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.